Hello there, this is Felipe, co-founder of Triplo AI. Today I'm going to share with you a use case of YouTube scraping that a user asked me on AppSumo. I'll take the advantage to show you around some new features and how to use the scraping capabilities of Triplo AI on it in the proper way. So let's begin scraping something in other language, and you'll see a new feature that we just released. In this example, the video is in Portuguese, actually in Brazilian Portuguese, and you see that there is these closed captions here, and you can copy the URL of it, bring Triplo AI to your screen, and if I try to scrape it as in the default, you'll see it won't work. I'll get this error message. There are no English captions on this video. But if I head to my settings and select Portuguese and try it again, you see that I have this full capture of the subtitles to work on. So let's clear this, head back to English. And now let's try something else. If I try to scrape this video, riding the Japan fastest bullet train, you'll see that there's no English captions. And actually in this video, there are no captions. So there's nothing that we can do with it. Triplo AI relies on the subtitles generated by YouTube to work on. But let's do something interesting, and I'll get back to the original reason of this video. I'm copying the URL of this video, and I'll do scrape the URL, and you'll see like a huge mass of content, because the way it's scraped, it's not like formatted or anything. And someone asked me, well, Felipe, you could do something to get this in a better fashion so I can work with it. And just occurred to me that I can do it. If I say something like organize the content off and throw in the URL, you'll see that it started trying to put pieces together in a better structured way. But this is not the original content of the subtitles. It's somehow work it on. And if you want to have the full content in more rigorous and factual as it was scraped, you could say something like, prompt here is don't change words or context or tone or anything on the following content. Just organize it in paragraphs. The content is. And if I hit enter, you see that it's parsing the content, but maintaining the original words and structure and the context. It's just better structured so you can work on. If you want to have this very same process throughout your next endeavors on YouTube, you can build a smart prompt for it. So I can say, I created this smart prompt, call it, and this is a normal smart prompt, YouTube organizer. It organizes scraped content from YouTube. And I just threw that prompt here. So don't change the words or context or tone or anything in the following content. Just organizing paragraphs. The content is, and then I'll save it here. And if I head back to Triplo AI, let's clean everything. And I start typing YouTube organizer. Let me find something in English with, let's find something. Here it is. I'm copying the URL and then bringing Triplo back to the screen. This should come already organized in paragraphs. See, AI is kind of slow today, but you got it. And here you have the full content, organize it. And you can play some more with it. You could have like instructions to make it word or generate the content in other languages. You could make the wording and the vocabulary easier to comprehend or use bullets. You see, this is part of the beauty of Triplo AI because you can play with your content the way you want. And it's like a blank canvas where you can do your tricks and think about creative ways of building this new content for you. I hope you enjoyed. If you need any assistance, just drop us a message. Thank you. Bye-bye.